almost all people in the Muhammadan Muslim world of Ummat Muhammad, as well as those who support the cause of the Palestinians anywhere in the world, do not actually know the facts behind the conflict or the origin of the names Palestine or Jew. In their erroneous perceptions, based almost entirely upon what they read or watch from a very biased media, the Palestinians are the underdog, the David against the Israeli Goliath. Three of the greatest tragedies of humanity are: 1. Ignorance of facts. 2. The refusal to learn from the best teacher of all time, history. 3. Invariably, the escape of the simplest truths from their attention. Ignorance allows the individual human being to be controlled, deceived, and manipulated by mostly selfish, arrogant, and unprincipled leaders. Those who do not learn from history are doomed to repeat it. Tragically, humanity assiduously repeats it in almost every generation. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an unfortunate reality that the simplest truths and facts invariably escape the attention or the intellect of most human beings, as I shall presently demonstrate. Most of the peoples that we know of, such as the Sumerians, Babylonians, Assyrians, Greeks, Persians, Romans, Egyptians, Aztecs, Mayas, Chinese, Indians, Europeans, etc., have left their mark on history with their legacy of writings and their monuments, or are mentioned by their neighbors or contemporaries. The Palestinian people, obviously, if they truly existed, should also have left their mark or are mentioned by others. If our academics, historians, politicians, and others are so sure that Palestine and its people go back throughout most of recorded history, one would expect them to be able to answer a few very simple and basic questions about the alleged country of Palestine and its people, the Palestinians. For example, when was the country of Palestine founded and by whom? Where did the Palestinian people originate from? What were Palestine's borders? Who were its neighbors? What language did the Palestinians speak? What writing did they use? What manuscripts or records did they leave, whether written or engraved? What was their religion? Where are their temples? What monuments attest to their existence? What was the name of their capital? Name its other major cities. What was their currency called? Are there any coins that attest to their economy? What was Palestine's form of government? Name its kings or rulers. What were their achievements? With what other people did the Palestinians interact? Where can we find any records wherein the name of the country of Palestine or its people are mentioned? What archaeological sites can one name? Where can one find the recorded history of these people? Whom did they conquer or were conquered by? Was Palestine ever recognized by a country whose existence at that time or even now leaves no room for misunderstanding? Can anyone name at least 5 Palestinian leaders before Arafat? Since there is no such recognized country today, what caused its demise and when did it occur? Those who are lamenting the low sinking of a once proud nation, please tell us, when exactly was this proud nation brought down? By whom was it brought down? Also, what was it so proud of? And here are some very important historical facts and further relevant questions. Not even under the Ottoman Empire's 500 years occupation was the name of Palestine used for any part or section of the Holy Land for administrative purposes. If there were an entity called Palestine and its people Palestinians, it would beggar logic and belief that the Muslim Ottomans would not denote the area with their name. After World War I, the British Mandate administered this very territory with the name Palestine, encompassing what is Jordan of today, as well as the territories of Israel, Gaza, and the West Bank. Palestine, after all, is only a name, bequeathed to history by the victorious Romans over the Jews of Judea. Contrary to their original mandate, the British unilaterally cut off from Palestine the territory east of the Jordan River and gave it to King Abdullah of the Hashemites, 35,637 square miles. What was left of mandated Palestine, 10,330 square miles, or 22% of the original, was divided by the United Nations between the Jews and the Arabs. If there was a geographic entity with the name Palestine and its people Palestinians, why is there no mention in the United Nations documents of the Palestinian people, but only of the Jewish people? Why were those alleged Palestinian people identified only as Arabs? Why are the refugees called Arab refugees and not Palestinian refugees by the United Nations if there were a territory identified as Palestine? If the people arbitrarily and mistakenly calling themselves Palestinians are anything but generic Arabs collected from all over the Arab and Muslim world, if they really have a genuine ethnic identity that gives them the right for self-determination, why then did they not declare their independence between the years 1948 to 1967? After all, during this long period of 19 years, there were no Israelis in the West Bank or Gaza. There were no settlements and there was no so-called Jewish occupation. Why did these Palestinians not declare their independence after 1948, but allow themselves to be occupied and marginalized for 19 years by their brother Jordanians in the West Bank and their brother Egyptians in Gaza? Why did the media and academia in the West not mention or be enraged by that occupation and oppression, not even once during the whole of its 19 years? Why were they deafeningly silent when the Arabs occupy the lands of other Arabs, but are indignant when anyone else occupies a square inch of any Arab or Muslim country, even when done in a justifiable war of self-defense? Why did the United Nations not have a single resolution condemning the Jordanian and Egyptian occupation of so-called Palestinian land during 19 whole years? Why did this allegedly proud and ancient people wait until after the Arabs had suffered their ignominious and devastating defeat in the 6 days war at the hands of Israel? Did they all of a sudden and miraculously find their alleged peoplehood and nationhood? I hope that everyone should avoid the temptation to trace the modern day Palestinians to the biblical Philistines, because substituting etymology for history will also not work. Disgustingly, this is exactly what the present desperate Arab so-called scholars of Islam are attempting to do. If one asks the Muhammadan Muslims of 1,500 million, including the alleged Palestinians, why are they called Palestinians, the probability of getting the correct answer would be almost zero. I shall now enlighten Ummat Muhammad of 1,500 million with the following devastating and unchallengeable facts. The name Palestinian is derived from the Hebrew Bible calling the Greeks, who had settlements on the coast where Gaza is, Plishtim, almost 3,500 years ago. This name, Plishtim, can only be found in the Bible and nowhere else, including all the records of the Arabs over the last 3,500 years. I would like to point out once more that these people, the Plishtim, were Greeks, not Arabs. After the death of King Solomon, his kingdom was divided into two states, Israel with its capital Samaria and Judea with its capital Jerusalem. This is exactly why the Jews are called Jews. Not because their religion is Jewish, but because of the name of their country of origin, Judea. Just like the English are called for being born in England and the Chinese because of China, so are the Jews so called because the name of the country of their nativity was Judea. Israel was conquered and many of its people were taken as slaves by the Assyrians. Judea survived a lot of vicissitudes, but was finally subjugated by the Roman Empire as the province of Judea. So-called believers and unbelieving kuffar, please remember that Jesus died on the cross as King of the Jews, crucified by the Romans over 2,000 years ago in the kingdom of Judea, in its capital, Jerusalem. And there was not a single Palestinian or a country called Palestine in sight. The ardently monotheistic Jews staged three major rebellions against the Roman occupation of their land and the desecration of the Temple of Solomon, the last of which was that of Bar Kokhba, 132 to 135 AD. After this bloody rebellion, the victorious Roman Emperor Hadrian purposefully changed the name of the province from Judea to Syria Palestina and Jerusalem its capital to Aelia Capitolina, in an attempt to erase the historical and spiritual ties of the Jewish people to their nation. To humiliate and denigrate the rebellious Jews, he deliberately changed the name of the Kingdom Judea to Syria Palestina, because as a learned man, he knew that the Philistine Greeks were among the worst enemies of the Israelites. He also changed the name of their capital Jerusalem to Aelia Capitolina, thus honoring the name of his wife, Aelia. The truth should be obvious to everyone and anyone who wants to know it. The Arabs of 330 million have never abandoned their dream of destroying Israel of 5 million Jews. They still cherish it today. Having time and again failed to achieve their evil goal by military means, they decided to fight Israel by proxy. For that purpose, they transformed the Arabs of Judea, Samaria, and Gaza into an ad hoc group, and as they publicly asserted, they cynically called it the Palestinian people. The so-called Palestinians have only one publicly and repeatedly declared motivation: the utter destruction of Israel, and that, as far as I'm concerned, is not a good enough reason to consider them a nation. It is one of the most remarkable of ironies that it was Muammar al-Qaddafi, the maverick Libyan leader who addressed a gathering of Arab heads of state summit and brought to their attention similar points that I have asked, and then adding insult to injury, said the following: the only way to achieve peace in the Middle East is for the Arab countries to acknowledge and accept Israel and to pay Israel reparations for the more than 50 years of devastation they have visited on it. 1400 years ago, Muhammad, the consummate pirate of the desert, robbed, raped, enslaved and slaughtered the pagan Arabs, Christian Arabs and Judaized Arabs. That was not enough for him, so he graduated to plagiarizing, plundering, pirating and or perverting from their scriptures, traditions and fetishes to concoct and compose his Quran, as well as a worthy ancestry for himself by pretending that all his verses were revealed to him by Allah, the supreme God of the pagan Arabs. His modern followers, the Muhammadan Arabs, in complete emulation of their mentor Muhammad and his Sunnah, concocted the myth of the so-called Palestinian people 1400 years later. Nothing ever changes in the depravities of the cult followers of Muhammad. Even after the lapse of 14 centuries, nothing ever changes. In conclusion, can anyone show the world any physical proof to indicate if there ever was an entity called Palestine and its people, the Palestinians? Can any Arab or so-called Palestinian disprove or refute anything I have just revealed, based entirely on answering the valid and logical questions that I have asked? Can any so-called Palestinian or any other human being answer the very simple but relevant questions above? I would like very much to hear from them. If not, why not? I rest my case.